The next circuit is decoder, one of the important circuits that we use in our system. Okay, so if we have n bits, we can represent 2 power n unique information, and decoder is a combinational circuit that will convert the binary information from n input lines to a maximum of 2 power n unique output lines. That is, to a maximum, we can have even less than 2 power n output lines, but to the maximum we can generate 2 power n output lines. Where it is used? In memories. Okay, say for example we have many memory locations and we have say 10 bit long address, and I am giving one 10 bit long input, and we wanted to uniquely identify the memory location addressed by this 10 bits. So we need to convert this n bit, which is 10 bit long, to one of 2 power 10 output lines, so that I can identify which memory location is represented by this 10 bit address. So decoder is used in such scenario. So we have n inputs and we have a maximum of 2 power n outputs. For example, consider 3 to 8 decoder. We have 3 inputs, 000, 001 and so on up to 111, and the output of this will be, when the input is 000, we have D0 to be 1, rest of them are all zeros. And when we have 001, D1 will be 1, rest of them are all will be 0. That is, this binary input is representing the memory location say 1, sorry 0, D0, and this is representing the memory location 1, which is D1, and so on. In other words, we can say that D0 is actually the minterm X bar, Y bar, Z bar. D1 is the minterm X bar, Y bar, Z, and D2 is the minterm X bar, Y, Z bar, and so on. So we can realize the decoder circuit like this. We have X, X bar, Y, Y bar, Z, Z bar, and D0 will be X bar, Y bar, Z bar. So we connect X bar, Y bar. Okay, this line is connected, and similarly the Z bar goes here. We can connect the literals corresponding to these minterm and generate the outputs of the decoder. So for any given input, any one of the D's will be 1, rest of them will be 0. It's quite common to use the decoder with the enable input, because if you consider this output D0, D0 will be 1 when all this X, Y, Z, all of them are zeros. That is, without any input, D0 will be 1. So we do not know whether we get the output of D0 to be 1 by applying the input to X, Y, Z as 0, or without any supply we get the D0 to be 1. If we are able to control whether this output D0 has to be taken as a valid output, it is better that we have the control to the circuit. This we achieve by the enable input. And in this example, we are using an active low circuit. That is, when enable is 0, the circuit is going to operate. Otherwise, the result of the circuit, we don't take it as a valid output. And instead of AND gate, we are going to use the NAND gate, because this is more economical gate that is available in the market. So when E is 1, that is enable is 1, since it is active low, that means that this is like normal 0 for us. Okay, and any input to A and B, it can be either 0 or 1, any input combination to A and B will result in all the bits of D0 to D3 to be 1. That is, since we have, this is an active low circuit and we have NAND gate, this is connected to all the NAND gates. So when E is 1, E dash will be 0 here, right? And when we supply 0 to all NAND gates, the result will be 1. And when this is active low, that is, we make E to be 0, E naught will be 1. In that case, the output of D0 to D3 will depend on the inputs of A and B. Thus, we have the control whether we need to take this output and interpret or not. Now, when this is active low, when X is 0, 0, our D0 should be active. Okay, all other bits will be 1. This is, since this is active low, 0 is active. So, D0 will be, so when we have 0, 0, this will be 1, 1. So, the lines corresponding to this, okay, we have here and we have B0 connected here. So, this D0 will be 0. So, all of them are receiving 1. So, AND operation will be 1. And we invert it to get a 0. So, D0 will be 0. Rest of them will be 1. Similarly, when we have, say for example, 1, 1, we have these lines. Okay. So, this is 1 and this line goes here as well. Okay. We have here 1. Rest of them will receive 0. We have A bar connected here, A bar connected here as well. Since A bar is 0, we will have 1, 1 here in for D0 and this one. For this one, we have connected A. So, this we will get 1, we will get 1 here. What about B? B bar is connected to this one and B bar is connected to this one. So, this will also have 1 as output. Here we have connected B, so we get a 1 output and enable is 0 and enable bar will be 1 and finally we get D3 to be 0. So at a time, any one of the lines between D0 to D3 will be 0, rest of them will be 1 since it is active low circuit. In addition to getting the control over the output of the circuit, or we have the control over when we can interpret the result of the circuit with the enable input, we can interpret the same circuit as a demultiplexer.